need so cute and everything, baby, I feel fine. Start a loving and you'll smile. Start a loving.
Who's a big of wine?
It's no time. It's time I look at you. Hey, hey, then you seem to thrill me through and through. You better do. I must admit that it is true. I'll throw a fit when I see you, baby. I like you because you have such loving eyes.
When I first met Tim, I was charmed by many things. His rugged good looks, his sense of humor, and his artistic ability. However, I was not so impressed by his fascination with clown cars. Not actual clown cars, mind you, although the cars he's into have been used in circuses, but Crosleys. My old man has four Crosleys. The Crosley convertible sedan you just saw, a Crosley station wagon, and two Crosley Supersports, one of which was that little red guy down front. I have often likened Tim's choice of vehicle to that of a glorified riding mower, which he has risked his life in for the past 10 years. Not only has he relied on a Crosley as his daily driver, he's also taken it on longer journeys from, say, Sacramento to the West Coast Crosley meet in Santa Barbara. Now you may be thinking to yourself, what is a Crosley? When I first saw Tim pull up in one, I thought it must be foreign because it was unlike anything I had ever seen. Many are surprised to find out that the Crosley is actually an American car. Powell Crosley began producing cars in 1939 and continued into the early 50s. In addition to autos, he also made the first refrigerator to have shelves in the door. The failure of Crosley's line of automobiles can be attributed to a variety of things, not the least of which is the fact that they are incredibly cheaply manufactured. To this day, a Crosley tire will only set you back about $12. The first year Tim and I were together, I was assured in no uncertain terms that the only thing that could potentially conflict with my birthday would be the annual West Coast Crosley meet, which he has not missed in 10 years. I initially dreaded spending an entire weekend with a pack of car fanatics. However, my mind was quickly changed after spending 2 days with a tight-knit gang of aging eccentrics. Up until 2004, when a series of mechanical issues required that he leave his Crosley at home, Tim made a point of actually driving his little car to the meet, no matter the distance. The trips earned him the coveted Travel Adventure Award and caused fellow club members to view him with a mixture of respect and confusion. This year's meet took place in Minden, Nevada. More than one attendee is there as a result of the Crosley being their first or second car growing up. There are also a handful of members who have become Crosley enthusiasts after inheriting the little cars from relatives. Given the fact that the Crosley went out of production in 1952, few people can recall a time when Crosleys existed as mass-produced automobiles.
How many people does it take to lift one?
Probably about 5 to really lift it. You can pick them up and bounce them around a little bit with 2 people. 3 would be better on the front with the engine weight. But not very much. And the joke in those days, because all the cars were big, these were really unique in those days. You wouldn't dare park it on the street because it wouldn't be there when you came back. It would be in front of the movie theater or at the door of the police station. They'd pick it up, carry it, or drag it down the street. And you could.
For many, these meets are important social gatherings for friends to reconnect, for Crosley enthusiasts to spend time with like-minded individuals, and to find out about unholy Crosley bargains. At this past meet, someone was offering up for sale an elusive FOB, or Fresh Out of Barn Crosley. These are like the Hope Diamond of project cars. Everything is original, it's all intact, and it's just waiting to be restored. There's also the opportunity to pick brains on restoration tips and resources for finding spare parts and services, as well as a chance to meet new friends. This guy showed up to the West Coast meet for the first time this year with a shiny gold Crosley coupe in tow.
Oh, these things go that way? Oh, I put mine upside down then.
Yeah, they go that way.
Oh, come on, Sciencey, what are we doing?
Well, we had to get that.
I'm okay there.
The tailgate hits
it. All right.
We're also in trouble, Barbie.
As the morning draws to a close, club members segue into the raffle, offering everything from Crosley parts and memorabilia to handicrafts, bubble bath, baked goods, and wine. In recent years, I've won hair care products, trivets made out of wine corks, and windshield cleaner. Following the raffle is an opportunity for Crosley buffs to do something that many look forward to all year. They get to drive their Crosleys en masse. Trailer their treasures, Tim will not be deterred. Every year I brace myself for the coming meet, knowing he'll be driving untold miles in a vehicle that's about as street-worthy as a tractor. While these undertakings don't necessarily make me jump for joy, my heart skipped a beat when I recently discovered him researching secondary roads to the national meet in Ohio.
I like you, thought you have such loving ways. Hey, hey, I like you, thought you are so sweet, so neat, so cute, and everything, baby, I like. Start a loving and you'll smile, start a loving.
Oh, oh, those are bigger blue eyes.
Hypnotized, every time I look at you. Hey, hey, didn't you see?